हाय एवरीवन, वेलकम टू स्टडी चैनल। आज 22 सितंबर 2019 आज जनरल स्टडीज पेपर फॉर जो आईएएस का एग्जाम था, तो इसका चलिए देखते क्वेश्चन देखते। इसका जो मैक्सिमम मार्क्स था 250 मार्क्स एंड 3 आवर्स था। क्वेश्चन पेपर जो था 12th था, सो टू सेक्शन में हिंदी एंड इंग्लिश बोथ में इसमें प्रिंटेड है। तो सेक्शन वन में जो पहला क्वेश्चन था, व्हाट आर द बेसिक प्रिंसिपल ऑफ पब्लिक लाइफ, इलस्ट्रेट एनी थ्री ऑफ दिस विथ द सुइटेबल एग्जांपल के साथ 150 वर्ड्स में। सेकंड क्वेश्चन था, व्हाट डू यू अंडरस्टैंड बाय द पब्लिक सर्वेंट, ओके रिफ्लेक्ट ऑन द एक्सपेक्टेड रोल ऑफ द पब्लिक सर्वेंट। नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, इफेक्टिव यूटिलाइजेशन ऑफ पब्लिक फंड्स is crucial to meet the development goals. Critically examine the reasons for the under the utilization and misutilization of the public funds and their implications. Next questions, non-performance of the duty by a public servant is a form of the corruption. Do you agree with this view? Justify your answer. Then next question, what is meant by the term constitutional morality? What does one uphold the constitutional morality? Next question is, what is meant by the crisis of the conscience? What does it manifest itself in the public domain? Next question, explain the basic principle of citizens' charter movement and the bring out its importance. Next question, there is a view of view that the Official Secrets Act is an obstacle to the implementation of Right to Information Act. Do you agree with that view? Discuss it. Next question, what do you understand by the probity in governance? Based on your understanding of the term, suggest measures for the ensuring probity in government. Next question, emotional intelligence is the ability to make your emotions work for you instead of the against you. Do you agree with this view? Discuss it. Chhatwa number question tha, what do each of the following quotations mean to do? Next question, in unexamined life is not worth living. Socrates. Next question, a man is but a product of his thought. What he thinks, he becomes M.K. Gandhi. 150 words mein likhna hai. Next question, where there is righteousness in the heart, there is beauty in the character. When there is beauty in the character, there is harmony in the home. When there is harmony in the home, there is order in the nation. When there is order in the nations, there is peace in the world. APJ Abdul Kalam. 150 words में लिखना था। सातवां नंबर क्वेश्चन आ गया, ये सेक्शन बी में आ गया, केस स्टडीज आ गया। जो पहला केस स्टडीज है, चलिए देखते हैं। You are heading the rescue operation in the area affected by several natural calamities. Thousands of people are rendered homeless and deprived of the food, drinking water, and other basic amenities. Rescue work has been disrupted by the heavy rainfall and damage to supply routes. The local people are seething with the anger against the delay, limited resource operations. When your team reached the affected area, the people they are heckled and even assault some of the team members. One of your team members is evenly severely injured. Faced with this crisis, some team members plead with you to call off the operations, fearing threat to their life. In such trying circumstances, what will be your response? Examine the qualities of the public servant, which will be the required to manage the situation. 250 words में लिखना था। अच्छा क्वेश्चन ही है, आपके हैंडल है, बहुत ही इजी क्वेश्चन भी है। चलिए नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन क्या है देखते हैं। सो नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज केस स्टडीज है, ऑनेस्टी एंड अपराइटनेस आर द हॉलमार्क्स ऑफ द सिविल सर्वेंट। civil servant possessing these qualities are considered as the backbone of any strong organizations. In line of duty, they take various decisions. At times, some become the bona fide mistakes. As long as such decisions are not taken intentionally and do not the benefit personally, okay, the officers cannot be said to be guilty. Though such decision may at times lead to the unforeseen adverse consequences in the long term. In the recent past, a few instances have surfaced wherein the civil servant have been implicated for the bona fide mistakes. They have often been prosecuted and even the imprisoned. These instances have greatly rattled the moral fibers of the civil servant. How does this trend affect the functionality of the civil services? What measures can be taken to ensure the honest civil servants are not implicated for the bona fide mistakes of their part? Justify your answer. 9 number question. In April, manufacturing the company having a large number of the women employees was losing sales due to the various factors. The company hired a reputed marketing executive who increased the volume of the sale within a short span of the time. However, some unconfirmed reports came off the regarding his indulgence in the sexual harassment at the workplace. After some time, a woman employee lodged a formal complaint to the management against the marketing executive about the sexually harassing her faced with the company's indifference in not taking the cognizance of her grievance. She lodged an FIR with the police. Realizing the sensitivity and gravity of the situation, the company called the woman employees to negotiate. In that, she was offered a hefty sum of the money withdraw the complaint and FIR, and also give the writing the marketing executive is not involved in this case. Okay, identify the ethical issues involving this case. What options are available for the women employee? The show number questions. In a modern democratic polity, there is a concept of political executive and permanent executive. Elected people's representative from the political executive and bureaucracy forms the permanent executive. Ministers frame the policy decisions and the bureaucracy executive these. Okay. In the initial decades after the independence, relationship between the permanent executive and the political executive are characterized by the mutual understanding, respect and cooperation. Without the encroaching upon each other's domains. However, in the subsequent decades, the situation has changed. There are the instance of the political executive instead of the open the permanent executive to the follow the agenda. Respect for the appreciation of the upright bureaucrats has declined. There is an increased tendency among the political executive to get the involved in the routines, administrative matters such as transfer, posting it. Under this scenario, there is a definitive trend towards the politicization of the bureaucracy. The rising of metallism and the acquisitiveness in the social life has been adversely impacted by upon the ethical values of both the permanent executive and the political executive. What are the consequences of the political of the bureaucracy? Discuss the 250 words mein. Then 12 number jo question hai wo hai, in the recent times there has been an increase the concern in the India for the to develop the effective of civil service ethics code of the conduct, transparency measures, ethics and an integrated system anti corruption agency. In the view of the there is a need being built for the focus of the specific areas. Which are the directly relevant to the problems of internalizing integrity and the ethics in the civil servants? Okay, ye sab hai, tino diya hai, yahan pe 250 words mein likhna hai isko.